सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तं वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and blessings and respects. Today's subject is tune into bliss. Before entering into the sutra, just few words. The first part of the book, Shiva was teaching meditation techniques related to different senses, like how to become enlightened through listening. If you are a music oriented person, if you are a musician, poet, how to take the jump, how to become enlightened. If you are visualization oriented, a painter, photographer, for this kind of people, he was giving technique. How to take a jump if you are taste oriented, tongue based. Understand? Taste oriented does not mean people who are eating too much. No. You eat too much because you are not able to taste. You become insensitive to food and the body. If you are eating too much, you become insensitive. You started abusing your body. That's the truth. People who can be very sensitive with the taste, for them he gave the techniques. Then he gave meditation techniques for the people who are more touch oriented, who experience deeper pleasure by touch, people who are lust based. For all kinds of human beings he was giving techniques. One beauty with Shiva's teachings, he is not rejecting any human being. He doesn't say no to anybody. That is the beauty. Patanjali will straight away cut off of the humanity. Straight away he says, you see, there are some people who are moral based, there are some people who are energy based. The energy based people will not fit with the social morality, and the moral based people will not directly experience the energy. For each kind of human beings, different path, different way is necessary. Patanjali addresses only the moral based people, do's and don'ts. Patanjali can't work with artists who are energy based. Usually the artists, spontaneous people, the energy based people will not fit with so called social moral standards. They will be little crazy. They will not fit with the standards. They won't bother about the regular so called social things. Patanjali can't work with them, but Shiva can work with everybody. That is why Shiva is considered as a Jagat Guru. He is the master of all human beings. He knows what all the moments you change gear, you shift the gear, what all the moments the unclutching happens inside you, and how to use all possible movements to push you to your center. Whether you believe it or not, inside your center you are enlightened. All of you are enlightened. All you need to do is be completely centered in all your actions. That's all. Somebody asked me the other day in one program. The same photograph was there in that program. One person asked me, what is this? You are blessing in that photograph. But usually when you walk into the room, you do namaskar. I bow down In photograph, it shows as if you are blessing. In reality, you are doing namaskar. I said, in both the activity, I do the same. When I bow down or bless, for me, it is one and the same. I don't feel I am big when I bless. I don't feel I am small when I bow down. I neither feel I am superior when I bless, nor feel inferior when I bow down. Both moments, I am completely centered on me. Just by being centered, even if you bow down, you will awaken the sense of respect and feeling connected in the other person. If you bless, again you will invoke the same presence or energy into that other being. If you are not centered, the blessing will look very egoistic. I always tell people, if you are not centered inside, never allow people to touch your feet. Because if people start touching your feet continuously, it's like an addiction. It feels so good. Ego is so cunning. I have seen this off-gurus. Off-gurus does not need any other punishment because they will create their own hell. All they need is little time. That's all. They don't need any other punishment. They can't be without their hell. They will feel that they are missing something if they don't create their hell. Off-gurus are the most dangerous people for themselves and for others. If you are not danger for yourself, you will not be danger for others. If you are not danger for others, you will not be danger for yourself. Being danger is, whether for you or for others, is one and the same. All masochists will be sadists. All sadists will be masochists. If you are torturing yourself, you will be torturing others. If you are torturing others, you will be torturing yourself. Torturing is a quality. With you or with others, you will be same. Accepting will be quality. With you or others, it will be same. I always tell people, accepting others without judging is not morality. It's a spiritual technique for peace, for bliss. Person who can accept others without judgment will have that same compassionate, beautiful words and inner chattering towards themselves. Towards themselves also. Because you don't use two kinds of inner chattering. Even though inside your mind you believe, for others I will show different face and for myself I will be different. I will forgive all my mistakes. I will judge only others' mistake. No, you can't. You can't. You are not that intelligent. You are not that intelligent. Intellectually, maybe you will be thinking, others, I will have a different rule and torture and rule and judge and put them, keep them all in track. For myself, I will be different. No. Judge will be the prisoner. All judges will be in the with the internal prison. Inside, they will be constantly judging them also, themselves. They will be constantly judging themselves. You may think, no, I know, I can be a little intelligent. I judge others, but when it comes to me, I have my own game. No. Maybe superficially you are believing. If you have the attitude of judging, condemning others, you will be doing that unconsciously, continuously towards you also. It's a basic mental setup, the quality. It is not just with somebody you will be different and with you will be different. No. These off-gurus are dangerous people. When they raise their hand, they feel that they are superior, that they are blessing the others. When they bow down, they feel that they are inferior. They are lower than others. It means they are not balanced in their all their actions. If you are centered, your very bowing down will be so graceful. It will create so much respect in others' mind. Being centered is the base of spirituality. Mahadeva knows all the movements in our life. When we unclutch, when we go through that shift, all those precious moments can be used. All those precious moments can be used to jump into the center, to fall in tune with the bliss consciousness. He knows how to use all those moments, precious moments. That is why he is creating 112 meditation techniques in your life. Whenever you jump from one chakra to other chakra, you unclutch, you shift the gear. See, any, whether you want to change from first gear to second gear, or second gear to third gear, or third gear to fourth gear, or fourth to first, you have to completely unclutch. The unclutching has to happen. Only then you can shift. You can't jump from straight away from one to two. No. The unclutching has to happen. Same way, Shiva knows all the movement, all the moments we unclutch in our inner space. If you have to jump from lust to fear, greed to fear, you have to completely unclutch. That small precious moment you experience, you are Shiva, you are Vishnu. Shiva means the most auspiciousness. Vishnu means all-pervading consciousness. That one moment you experience, you fall in your center, you get centered. He knows what all the moments you go through, that shift, how you can use that moment to take the jump or to center yourself. There is a beautiful story. Let me tell the story, then we will understand the meaning before entering into the today's sutra. Brahma. Brahma is a representative of intellectual understanding. Vishnu is the representation of devotion. People who are centered on intellect, for them, Brahma is the ideal. That is why Veda, intellectual knowledge, Brahma is the God for that. People who are heart-oriented, emotional, sensitive, for them Vishnu is the ideal. Filled with love, always in bliss, great joy, radiating the love. Basically, the followers of Vishnu will be bhaktas. And if you are being-oriented, strong, energetic, introvert, centered, you will be Shiva's follower. Even the ideals are created in that way only. Shiva's followers will be more people who are working towards enlightenment, meditative, yogis. Vishnu's followers will be more devotees, flowing with the devotion, ecstatic, joyful. And Brahma's followers, or the people who feel connected to Brahma, will be more intellectual, analyzing, analyzing, analyzing. This Brahma is described with five heads. It seems initially he had five heads, but slowly he became arrogant, started thinking. Shiva is also described with five heads. He started thinking, Shiva is also having five head and I am also having five head. I think I am equal to Shiva. I am equal to Shiva. He started thinking he is equal to Shiva. Even if you think it's okay, sometimes they start behaving. That's where the problem starts. That's where the problem starts. He started behaving, he is equal to Shiva. And he started expressing everything just like that he is Shiva. Shiva is a cosmic energy, cosmic consciousness. He started behaving or expressing himself like a Shiva. Then story says, from Shiva's being, the Kalabhairava. Kalabhairava means the lord of time. That energy came out and cut one head of Brahma to teach him that he is not equal to Shiva. This is the story, mythological story. If you just ordinary way approach this story, you will think, oh, then Shiva is also jealous like Brahma us. Why did he send somebody to cut the Brahma's head? It is not just mythological. It is not supposed to be taken as a fact. It is a truth. Understand? There is a difference between fact and truth. Fact is what you understand with your logic, with your intellect, with your understanding of time and space. Truth is a great ideology expressed in metaphysical terms. This story is not directly fact, but it expresses a great truth. The meaning of the story is, anybody who gets deep intellectual understanding but still not yet experienced, they also start behaving like a Brahma. They start thinking, I think I have got it. I have seen many people. They will come and spend some time around me for 6 months or 1 year. By that time, their intellect feels convinced. Actually, if you are constantly listening to these ideas, even if you don't meditate, at one point, your intellect will feel completely satisfied and convinced. That is a beautiful point if you continue to work with the master. That's a dangerous point if you stop connecting with the master. That's the most dangerous point, because you will start thinking that now you have it everything. I have seen these people after a year or something. Once they know all the ways of intellect, they think that they know the business secret now. They think they know the business secret. They think, I am an insider now. I know all the business secret. And they really start thinking they got it. They have become enlightened. They start thinking they have become Shiva. Being in the state of a Brahma, they start thinking they have become Shiva. Being just in the state of that intellectual understanding, they start thinking they have become Brahma. Same problem with five head. The Brahma's five head, Shiva's five head. Both may have five head, but it's not that both heads are working in the same way. Just because Shiva is also having five head and Brahma is also having five head, you can't say both are same, because how things happen inside the head matters, not just the head. I've seen these people, by the time they spend 1 year and learn some basic ways of teaching, expressing and telling, giving little guidance, counseling. If they can give some counseling to few people and help them to get healed, they think, now they have become Shiva. They don't need anything else now except one throne. Now all they need is one throne to sit. Most dangerous moment in the life. Then naturally the Kala Bhairava, the lord of time, will appear and remove at one point the five head which you think you have. One head will be removed. Then suddenly you realize you have not yet become Shiva. You have only four head. You are missing something. But learning from Kalabhairava will be too strong. If life teaches, if time teaches, Kalabhairava means time. Kal means time. Lord of time, if time teaches, it is very dangerous. Learning from master will be very sweet experience.